All right.
Look alive. Look young.
Not being photographed. I'm being interviewed.
You're being interviewed by Peter Jennings.
You're on video.
World News Tonight.
All right. You're supposed to be an observer, not a commentator.
All right, so let's start off. Just tell me, like, about anybody who, like, came before in your family that was involved in either World War One or World War Two.
Okay. Dad was Thomas Joseph Creighton.
All right.
Was in the Navy prior to World War One.
All right.
And he was in time that Teddy Roosevelt was president, and Teddy Roosevelt decided to send the U.S. Navy around the world to show our power. He was on that thing.
Okay. So
and he told me that he went around the world before he was 18 years old.
Okay. So when he joined World War One, was it in, like, 1917 when the U.S. first went over to World War One?
That's about the right time.
So did he have any involvement in World War One?
Yeah.
Sure did.
Yeah.
Was he in any, like, specific battles or?
Well, he was on a battleship and a destroyer.
All right.
And he told me that he had several encounters with German soldiers.
Okay.
And he was gun captain or battery captain.
All right. What do you remember? Like, was he in a specific class or ranking?
Yeah, it's an enlisted man's classification on an officer's it's sort of like petty officer.
All right. So there's one question that I have to ask. It's mandatory that I ask it. So did he write, like, I know you weren't alive yet, but did he write, like, a lot of letters home, or was
I have no idea, but I do have his discharges from the Navy twice, once before World War One, and then after World War.
All right. So he lived on the ships, right? And when he was
pretty much, yes.
All right. Did you know if he carried any, like, good luck charms, or was there something he carried?
I have no idea.
All right. So let's see. What's the next? Okay. So, do you have any?
He was head of this gun group on a battleship, and they were firing at a submarine, and his gun blew up. Why, I don't know, but that was a common occurrence in those days. And he said that he was the only one to survive out of the gun group.
Wow.
And he woke up 9 months later in Norfolk Hospital out of a coma.
Alright. So let's move on to World War II. So what were your exact
affiliations? Well, there's one thing that you should have added.
Alright, add it.
When he went home, his entire family, five sisters, his mother, his father, wiped out, flew up in the
day. Alright. Okay, so let's move on to World War II. So what were your exact affiliations, or, like, what exactly did you do with World War II? I know you were young, but...
Well, I grew up during the time the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor.
Alright.
And I was about 14, 13.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember December 8th that lights in Los Angeles are broken. Mm-hmm.
There's a question here. Do you remember, like, what the feelings were around Los Angeles about Japan being attacked, or Japan attacking Pearl Harbor for any, like...
Well, yes. The junior high school I was going to had a lot of Japanese. Mm-hmm. They were there before December 7th, and gone after December 7th.
All right. Did you know where any of them were...
Well,
like which camps they were taken to?
Yes, I do, because a friend of mine was a carpenter, and he was working on their concentration camp near Sacramento, San Jose.
Alright. Did you ever, like, you said you were involved for a little bit, like, what exactly time period was that?
Well, it was 1947. Immediately after graduating from high school. And I got drafted into the Army Air Force.
Right.
My idea was to be a pilot. Mm-hmm. And after I got in, they reached the age limit from 18 to 21, so I didn't make it. But 11 months later, there was a general release of anybody that wanted to get out of the service. And I took that.
So you were drafted, but then they raised the age limit, so you just decided to take what they were offering. All right. So during the war, when you were in school, like what precautions or what was the school telling you, or any outside information? Like what information were you getting about the war?
Well, I followed it just out of curiosity as a kid. Had a big map, and I was watching the specifically the German invasion of Russia, and I kept pins on the map, and I could see where they were going and what happened during that period of time.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you remember any, like, individual, like, do you remember, what was that, D-Day, when the...
I was delivering mail at 14.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember, like, the feelings or the emotions that were going around?
Just exploded. Mm-hmm.
And, like,
everywhere.
Just, like, everybody was super happy, or?
Happy.
Alright. Do you remember when the war ended, the exact day? It was August 14th or April 14th, something like that?
Well, there were two endings. One when Germany quit, mm-hmm. and then when Japan. The one I remember best was the German one, because that one was we had standing instructions to get off the streets immediately, which I did. But remember, I was a 14-year-old kid.
Right. All right. Let's see. Hold on. Okay. So you have a story about VJ.
VJ.
All right. This is pretty.
I was on Catalina Island.
Alright.
And all the military there, of course, were, you know, in housing and things in the part of it. Well, the whole island burst loose. All the servicemen were running freely all through the island. It was the most exciting and thrilling day I had ever had. Right. Happy to everybody at BJ at
Perfect. Do you remember, was your father in World War II as well? Or
no, only me. And also I was in the Korean War.
All right.
I haven't got there.
Yeah, all right. So what was it like after the war? So, I mean, the war ended, but then just slowly as it got further and further away from the ending, what were the emotions like? How did you celebrate in what ways?
Well... It was more of a, since I was living in Southern California, all these troops and Navy people had gone through their World War II, and there was just a tremendous explosion of population in the town I grew up in, Los Angeles. voted in as they just threw up thousands and thousands and thousands of people. So the whole culture of the city changed.
So do you remember any like specific events that happened where people were just storming the city or parties were going on? Any like
I know that Hollywood and Vine was a focal point of celebration there before, like Times Square was in New York, and it was on radio and it got television.
Alright. Is there, just going back to World War One, was there any places where you knew that your father fought?
Well, I think it's important that, I don't know the specifics, but I do know that prior to World War One, as I mentioned, did you ever hear of the termination definition, Great White Fleet?
No.
That was Teddy Roosevelt's description of what he was doing there. And my dad said he went everywhere. He went to Woodstock, Japan, China, Europe.
So he was sailing around the Pacific during the time of World War One, and then
before
World War One, and then when the U.S. joined World War One, when he went over to Europe.
Well, he was he'd gotten out of the Navy for a period of time. I don't know how long, but it wasn't too long, because in those days you joined up for 6 years after the show. And then when the war came out, he just re-enlisted, back in his old rank. So,
and then he went over to Europe.
He was in the Atlantic.
Alright. No, that's a good question. There you go.
Well, I went into the Army Air Force as a basic trainer in Texas. And we're going to send me to mechanics school in Denver. But then I had a
did he do anything else? Do you remember anything?
Well, he got a Bronze Star, I know that.
Mm-hmm. So, his like, do you remember exactly when he came back?
Yeah, I sure do, because he married my sister.
Alright. Did you remember?
And that was 1946 or 7.
Do you remember any stories that he told you about something that happened?
You know, it's interesting, but none of the veterans really
didn't really want to
talk about
it.
The war. Mm-hmm.
Was there anything?
It's only later that I found out some of this.
Anything later? Any little tidbits or?
Well, I do know that. I saw him when he was still in uniform after World War II, and he had a lot of time.
So, he was pretty...
And then he after World War II, he decided
would, every time there was like a bombing, they would like hide in caves. One of the things that she was really fascinated about was she would watch the dogfight, the Japanese and the U.S. planes fight. And she thought that was great. She was, you know, in her early 20s when she went to that war. But she said it was a live show that she would always remember. But then she would tell us stories that she actually became friends with a lot of Japanese soldiers. She would wash her clothes or barter with them. And she actually, there was one story that she told that there was one soldier that got lost and was looking for some food or something to drink. And the Filipinos around them told him to, you know, get a coconut. Well, the guy was drinking coconut, and the guy said, "Let's slash his back." Didn't set off. But then my mom, she knew how to speak Japanese, so she told the guy what he was going to do, so the guy was able to.
Do you remember if you ever told him to take off the top of the
ocean? Yes. I could make one up. Yeah.
Do you remember anything about that, Pops? Do you know what that word was?
Yes, I do. As a kid, during high school.
So what exactly was the poem then?
Well, it was after Corregidor surrendered, and the Gardener left the Philippines for Australia. And they were marching them north up the peninsula, and I guess it was just horrendous. I don't know what percentage, but a large percentage of American troops died. Lights on your car. addition, they bop wire all the beaches from Malibu to Tahiti.
So nobody was allowed on any beaches during that time? So, they placed barbed wire on the beach, or, above?
Yeah, it was they called it concertina wiring, and they just laid it right along the beach.
Was there any ever, Japanese, did you ever see them, out on the ocean?
No, but there was one incident that I was aware of, up in Northern California, Japanese submarine. Bombarded some of the roads. A lot of this is not general information. Mm-hmm. It's just that I have to remember.
Exactly.
The war you didn't
know. The Japanese were sending those balloons, right? With the bombs?
Well, they...
So they were sending bombs?
They just balloons, balloons with bombs on them. And
the westerly or the easterly winds blowing too much.
Whatever it was, yeah.
Like Catalina Island, only the people that had the property there were watching them. So I had a high school program, had a house there, and all the high school kids went to go and spend time with them. But nobody else could tell the question actually.
We know the Japanese submarines were spotted in between Catalina.
So they were pretty close.
Oh, yes. We didn't have any Navy